Now you're with Sky Living HD.
Coming up on tonight's Grape Juice, we'll be talking about the Australian bombshell that's taken the nation by storm, Iggy Azalea. Finding out which celeb should be locked up by the fashion police. Looking at exclusive pictures and footage from behind the scenes of teen heartthrob Jaden Smith's new movie After Earth. And later on with our very own Grape Juice exclusive, we'll be accompanied by Stephanie Anderson and Kareem Johnson, the stars of Sky Living's new soap, Less Than Perfect.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Grape Juice, giving you all the latest and juiciest gossip through the grapevine. I'm Shannon Cadney.
And I'm Terrell Stewart.
So earlier I mentioned that we have Stephanie Anderson and Kareem Johnson in the studio with us, which
yeah,
we do.
That'd be good, that'd be really good.
But first, let's go to Makisha, who has all the latest gossip in current affairs, music and movies.
Thanks, Shannon. So Iggy Azalea is a name that's been on the scene, most recently with her controversial song, Pussy. The 22-year-old Australian high school dropout grabbed everyone's attention back in 2011 when she released her mixtape, Ignorant Art. Her most recent release work is her first single to be lifted from the Aussie's debut album, The New Classic, which will be released later this year. In other news, we have Jaden Smith following in his father's footsteps in his new sci-fi film, After Earth. The couple play father and son who have crash-landed to Earth 1,000 years after events forces humanity's escape. The two join forces and embark on a perilous journey to signal for help in order to get rescued and return home safely.
Crash-landed. 2 confirmed survivors. This is a class 1 quarantined planet. Everything has evolved to kill humans. Son, do you know where we are?
No, sir.
This is Earth.
The film is due to be released on the 31st of May in IMAX and the 7th of June in other theatres. In other news, it's a well-known fact that Madonna is dating one of her tour dancers, Brahim Zaibat. The couple weren't shy in displaying their PDA when they shared a raunchy kiss on stage during a show in Brazil. Since then, the 50-year-old pop legend has been victimized due to a major wardrobe malfunction. She was spotted in Manhattan with her boyfriend, Brahim. Wearing an Oakley ski cap, a light scarf tied around her neck, a full-length sweater, sweatpants tucked into black and white United socks, and black combat boots. The Material Girl's outfit was either a cutting-edge fashion statement or the result of needing something to wear on a laundry day. Meanwhile, Brahim kept his outfit much simpler, sporting a leather jacket, grey hoodie, t-shirt and jeans. Despite there being nearly 3 decades of age difference, the two have been together for nearly 3 years now. Aww. In more devastating news, JLS have announced they will be splitting up after 6 years together. The band that rose to fame on the 2008 series of X Factor were runners-up behind Alexander Burke. They have achieved great commercial success off the back of the show, with 5 chart-topping singles, 3 platinum-selling albums, and records of sales over 10 million. The group intends to bow out with their greatest hits tour in December 2013. They will still continue to work with charities close to their hearts. Thank you, I'm Makisha Luke. Back to you, Shannon.
Wow, who would have thought they would have broken up?
I know, right? It's terrible. I'm sad.
Well,
I'm sad.
On a more positive note,
now it's time for Frock Off. This week we have Kim Kardashian and Zoe Saldana wearing a nude baby doll dress. Now, although Kim is pregnant, 67% of you thought Kim wore it better. I thought so too. Here we've got Kamora Lee Simmons and Kristen Stewart wearing a salmon pink optical illusion Herve Lager dress. While Kamora tried to sophisticate it off as a top with a pair of black leather pants and black ankle boots, Kristen was much more daring, showing off her long slender legs with black pants. The votes are in, with a whopping 97% of you agreeing that Kristen wore it best. Anna De La Russo and Rita Ora were both spotted wearing a Saint Laurent sequin embellished Pussy Boat asymmetric dress. Rita wore this ensemble to a CoverGirl event and looked stunning. However, the same can't be said for Anna, as she was dressed a bit too young for her age. 92% of you said Rita wore it best. And finally, we have the person you voted as our worst dressed celeb. Florence Welch, wearing a custom Givenchy at the 2013 Grammy Awards. The Florence and the Machine singer looked like something out of a Doctor Who episode, rather than a diva. I think you need to rethink your wardrobe stylist, love.
That's it for this week's Rock Off.
I caught up with Stephanie Addison and Kareem Johnson. Should we have a look at their interview?
We shall.
Okay.
She's all right. Decent body.
Yeah, don't worry, I'll be fine.
I'm a star athlete at this school. I'm going places.
How did this happen? How do you have to be so careless?
So, this is all we have time for today, but next week...
Next week we'll be talking to Hollyoaks stars Texas and Dodger.
I know. They're here to talk about Texas's murder. Exciting things, I know. Exciting.
So, join us next week on Grape Juice, giving you all the latest and juiciest gossip through the grapevine.
But for now, take care.
Bye. Bye. Good night.
So what do you think of it all? You can tweet us on our Twitter page at Grape Juice or leave a comment on our website www.grapejuice.co.uk.